ओम सर्व मंगल मांगल्य शिवे सर्वार्थ साधके शरण्ये त्र्यंबके गौरी नारायणी नमोस्तुते। ओम शंभो शंभो। Who am I? This is a beautiful question that presented itself in front of me again and again for more than a decade. At one point of time, and in all those years, I was like a child wanting to know. I was a seeker, at times innocent, at times doubtful, at times hopeless. At times, even arrogant and ignorant, and at times beautiful and pure. And then finally, after years of a meandering chase, quite not the way I planned or expected, the sun finally dawned upon me. The cup is empty. The void is infinite. The nectarial word keeps dropping. And I am all bliss. Nothing is more beautiful than the void that I experience every moment, every muhurta, every day. In this void, there is no day, no night. In this void, there is no sun, no moon, no light, no darkness. No ignorance, no reasoning, no analysis, no philosophy, no body, no thought, no reason or logic. My entire cup is filled with void, and hence it is empty. A filled cup and yet an empty cup. The bliss or ananda that comes with it is inexplicable and incomparable. It cannot be compared to anything worldly that we see, hear, say, read, taste, touch, think, or calculate or analyze. It is beyond all that. It is beyond all of that. It is beyond the senses and beyond the creation. It exists in every speck of space, and yet it is beyond space. I am its lover, its servant. I live with this. Every moment, every day. When I live with this truth, there is no mortality. My life of bliss is beyond space and time. My life of bliss is beyond this physical and mortal. In that life, there is no pain, no misery, no suffering. I know now that suffering in physical realms and physical incarnations is only temporary, What is permanent is bliss, my dear friend. And I am fortunate enough to be immersed in it. I am not afraid of death or suffering anymore. Because in all of that, I see a story separate from my truth. The ultimate truth that I live with, that I live in. The eternal, ever youthful, and ever fresh beyond age truth. These stories can come and go. They have come and gone like a blink and miss appearance in my existence. But the eternal truth story of mine has always been there. This separate story is different from truth. Since we are not able to see the complete truth and the complete package that we are, this worldly life is like an illusion. Because we are not able to realize and perceive it in the light of the larger truth, or rather, the largest truth, the ultimate truth. It is a reality that is beautiful. And if we are able to realize it, then we can fulfill the mission of our human incarnation. Being human, my dear friends, is not a pain. It is an opportunity to serve the giver. It is an opportunity to serve the divine, the divinity, the very current of life itself. Be it, be with it, the eternal truth. We need to realize the beauty of this life, my dear friend, this creation. The suffering will vanish. It vanishes if we are immersed in bliss. If we are beyond and yet within, everything becomes part of an eternal, immortal, and ever continuing beauty and bliss. We come, fulfill our purpose, go back to where we came from, and come back when it is time. If we are able to see everything, including these material realms, from the seat of the void, from the seat of the truth, from the seat of bliss and truth, then, my dear friend, everything is truth. However, materialism becomes illusion when we look at it from a different place, a place of ignorance. Life lived with ignorance is difficult.